Welcome back to Off-Frame Productions. We are, of course, playing Chroma Squad. Chroma Squad? It's a fun-ass game, man. Now, if you remember on the last episode, the last couple of episodes, so we're having a problem currently. Kira is starting to become a little bit of a bitch. Also, I do kind of suck, but Kira is, she's taking a bit of headway, and she's her head is getting big. All right, we're a group of friends. We started our own company, and well, I mean, somebody has to take charge, I guess, or at least that's what Kira thinks. Anyways, we're on to the next episode, where All-Frame Productions was invited to an anime convention. Hail to the yeah! Our heroes meet mini fans and go look for a cupcake. But this won't be any ordinary snack at all. If this is a demon cupcake, I'm gonna be honest, that's gonna be pretty funny. Alright, so let's go ahead and start. Oh look, it's a rainbow anime man. I love anime conventions. I've always loved conventions. It's just, it's cool. I actually don't buy shit, or I actually don't go for a lot of things, but I go to meet people. And people are kinda cool. But conventions are fun nonetheless. And no way, Eden is way cooler. Let's see. I'm actually hungry. Do any of you want a cupcake? I'm going to grab a few ones. Okay, that's, I don't know. A few ones just seemed weird. Yeah, no, totally. Cupcakes, not gonna be dangerous at all. What the hell? Hi, my name is Steve McFeely. No. That name just scares the shit out of me. How can I help you? Yes, I want some cupcakes. I do want some cupcakes. I wasn't selling any, but this, well... Come on, Kira, you gotta learn to read. Let's see. Everyone vanished from the conference, and this creepy dude jumped out of the shadows. Fuck. I can't just have a normal day. He told me that I needed to sell this cupcake to someone important. I guess it was you. Do you want this magical cupcake? It's glowing. It is glowing. Well, this is certainly very odd. I will take two. I want two cupcakes. Damn it! Well, something's going on. Oh, Kira. You're kind of becoming a bitch now. And I do wanna say one thing. Bitch in the vernacular is anybody, male, female, dog, that is being stupid, beyond stupid, and full of themselves. I apologize if you take it in the wrong talk, if you think I'm talking in the wrong way, but ultimately, Kira is being a douche. Suddenly, a really weird sound echoes around the place. And the seemingly delicious cupcake transforms into a terrible monster. Oh my. Ah, dangerous cupcake. No, you were supposed to split me into tiny pieces and eat me like a team. Yeah, come on, Kira. You're supposed to do that. And then I would explode you from... Fuck! That is actually a very devious plan, Cupcake Man. But Kira's a dumb. Kira's a, you know, she's dumb right now. Everything makes sense now. Am I on the show? This is amazing! Obvious is, that's why they call me the Evil Cupcake. That's... I like how your, like, toppings aren't even on connected to your head. Okay, so, look, okay, so we got an evil cupcake. Let's, Sweet as sugar, hard as ice. Hurt me once and I'll beat you twice. This guy's a poet. Wait, oh, okay. There you are. I was wondering what was coming out from here. Alright, so we know the deal from here. There are enemies. I got to punchy-punchy the enemies. And then, I got to punchy-punchy the cupcake.
This odd little clipping to the wall, but I'll be honest, I don't really care. This game's so dumb, I don't care.
It's dumb in the good way. Wait a second. Are you allowed to call out these minions? So unfair. Then I call myself to help color-coded as an apology for trying to sell you into your bellies. Ah, son of a bitch. No, definitely. Not just some random fan, Rule 34. I'm a great mathematician and have developed great math skills that can be very useful. Mostly versus monsters. What? How? I mean... What? I don't know what's going on. How does math fight enemies?
Anyways, defeat two enemies on the first turn. Easy.
Defeat all minions.
Yeah, that's easy.
Alright. I'm under no time limit, so how? Come on. Okay, how are you looking, Miss Ely? Attack. Decent. Actually, McFeely is actually pretty powerful when it comes to attacks. So we'll just have him.
And you have an axe.
You have an axe.
Whatever. Him and Avatar will just take this guy out.
Okay, hold on. I'm actually gonna do something a bit odd here. I'm gonna triple attack these guys just to be certain.
That took 370. Yeah, I'm gonna have no problem taking out all of these, but I want to be sure that I get two enemies on the first turn.
Doesn't seem too difficult, but I do want to make sure they did. And ultimately, if you did, you did.
And because of this, I am gonna triple attack these guys. I don't need to triple attack these guys, but I will triple attack these guys just to be certain.
Because I'm under no time limit, and all I have to do is take out all of the enemies, this episode might run a little long. And more than likely, I'll probably just cut out... Son of a bitch. Goddamn mine.
Goddamn, TNT. There might be a chance where I'm going to overstay my welcome, and I'm just going to have to...
What the hell?
You... Okay. Let me... Let me stop and think. This guy licked me through a turtle. And then attacked me with his tongue. I mean, it
is what it is. I'm not even questioning it anymore. Shit, I didn't want to go.
You know what? I'm just gonna send McFeely and these and Avatar to take these guys out and then just slowly whittle everybody down. Let's see.
Rule 30. Smash Mouth can more than likely take out an enemy by herself, but just in case, Rule 34 is gonna go hang out with her.
Yeah, that's an easy one person KO. Like Smash Mouth is really strong.
I'm gonna have to chromatize here in a second, probably after this explosion.
And like three or four turns, if they keep doing these things. Ultimately, is this gonna be a problem? No. I'm gonna have enough time to max out all of my fans. I'm gonna have to do all that stuff. It's gonna be a problem. Not gonna be a problem. Fuck you, giant cupcake. Ah, shit.
There is a problem that we're currently facing.
I guess mathematical X.
You know, I thought you would do more.
I really thought you were gonna do more there.
Okay, so let's get everybody up close and personal.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to chromatize on this turn. Everybody's getting a bit too low. I'm so glad they...
Go after the ones who can survive this turn.
Oh fuck, Smash Mouth is so close to dead.
Who do I want to? Let's get...
Everybody chromatized around you. Now with this, now we've opened up a whole bunch of possibilities. Now, one thing that does come to mind. Roundhouse kick should take him out. Fuck. But I got to go help me mix the healing. Again, not a problem. Not a problem. We just gotta get everybody out. Everybody has to take care of themselves. Really, I'm actually very surprised you didn't kill them. I'll just sword you. I don't care. You're gonna die. Yeah, I know you can finish it. Actually, I'm not too worried about you. Again, all I want to do is kill the minions. Be sure to get our little bonus, and we're good. We're gonna go ahead and just speed it up until we get to the murder of the evil cupcake, who, by the way, is pure evil. All minions dead, and it's finally the cupcake's turn. Now, oh, actually, you did the best thing possible. You did the best possible thing. Now all I have to do is surround you. And you did. You know what, let's get Mr. McFeely in here as well. Can I get Mr. McFeely? Yeah, I can get Mr. McFeely. And then, you did. I kind of want there to be Miss McFeely here, and then just like him just throw down an axe or something. Wasn't impossible, kind of tease. No. Steven, thank you for your help. It was a great time battling with you, by your side. Now that the evil cupcake is gone, maybe people will be back, and I'll be able to keep selling my hot dogs. Your name is Mr. McFeely, and you sell hot dogs. I don't know, man. That... I'm kind of scared. Kind of scary. Anyways, have I mentioned that Color Coded is a great indie show, and hugely inspiring? Watch Color Coded last night. Watch Color Coded Latest. Join us for our Sentai podcast at 8 p.m. Yeah. Really impressed at the latest episode of Color Coded. At Volvo Software. Why Volvo no dire monsters? Want fight mecha. Want mecha fight. Now, we do have some we got some emails. Definitely have to answer our stuff. Because, here we go. Dear person who is playing the game, I was looking at your increased income. I think it's time for a little salary upgrade. Would you consider it? Mine first, then Sunday League. Thank you. Attached, your info. Come on, Kira. Really? Really? Breaking the fourth wall? I don't mind. I perfectly love breaking the fourth wall. But come on. You can't be like this. Though, that being said, all of you do deserve a raise. See what it says. Hooray. Juro Sushi has never been so close. I've been saving for quite some time. Well, you know what? I'm glad. I'm glad that you guys can eat now that I am paying you more. Dear manager of Offering Productions, your show has been a bright light during this dark night of government lies and misinformation. You are fighting the good fight, letting people know that there's a real threat out there. And they walk among us, controlling mainstream television's pop music. However, I could not help but notice a few misdetails and misrepresentation in your fiction. I'm a professional in these men. In these matters, and for a small sum, I can consult for you and ensure that your next episode are 100% faithful to real extraterrestrial culture. I'm going to read that back to you. I am a professional in these matters, and for a small sum, I can consult for you and ensure that your next episode are 100% faithful to real extraterrestrial culture. 80 dollars to have some guy tell me how aliens exist and are, or to tell him aliens are not real. Now here's the problem. I believe in aliens. I believe in the statistical ability of there to be aliens. How does one answer this? It's not really a hard decision, it's more of me being difficult. Do I want to admit to this guy? Sure, I'll give you $80 to tell me how to possibly ruin my show because of your potentially information, which may or may not be correct, about aliens. Or I tell him aliens are not real and lose fans. But he's insane. Fuck it, I'm gonna do it. Aliens are real. Sure, I'll give you $80. Glad to do business with you. It was a very productive afternoon at Offering Productions. I hope you have learned more about the nature of these aliens. As a parting gift, I have left a pile of oozing black filth hidden in your kitchen sink. It is 100% legit alien material. Don't let it go near any miniature black holes. Black goo. Money decreased. Where is it? Tell me, where are you? Damn it! It's not black goo, it's vinyl. Crafting materials. What do I have? Like, I don't know what I actually have in terms of things. And he left me a pile of black goo, which, I mean, cool? I don't know. I mean, fuck. Shop. Can I sell some? Sell stuff? Studio, actors, whatever. Anyways, this will be it for today's episode. It has been fun. I know of aliens because they exist. Sure. Anyways, and look, let's be completely honest. At this point of the game, this dude's a total alien. This brain in a jar, it's an alien. See this cat? I'm sorry, it's not a cat. You see this? Extraterrestrial kitten. See that? It's a Hoover vacuum. And he's a monster in the next episode. Anyways, it's been fun. My name is Chris. I hope you guys enjoyed the Offering Productions and Chroma Squad. I shall see you guys tomorrow. Later.